Morning all. Listen, you have no idea where we are. Tim says to me, make sure you've got a good background in all this. Forget the background. I'm off to England on Thursday. I picked my pal up, Big Kevin, my number 5 from Middlesbrough. And we've just done a nice 15-minute questions and one or two other bits and pieces. That will go out the weekend.
Which failed miserably.
Yeah, because the gimbal. Oh, it didn't want to work. It's obviously just woke up the gimbal. So we mess it. It's going this right, that right. So it doesn't matter. We've done it. We've been there.
Bill Gates has nothing to worry about.
Oh, God. If you just tuned in, it's Webby Sports Road up here. It's Sunny Tenerife in my mouth. Right, listen. We found this little bar. I've been there a couple of times with the missus. Kevin's not been in this corner, so I thought we'd bring him down. We've had a little walk down to the pool.
You need a passport to get in here. You need a... Because it's a bit expensive.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, you have no idea.
The property's a moon.
Right. We're in Swainers Hall, just up the road from Purley Grey, where I live, in a little bungalow village. There's apartments around here on the corner, and we're in a little cafeteria. It's only been open 2 or 3 months. Lovely little place, and it's called La Tortufita. Okay? That's as good as you're going to get it from me. Little bar, just little snacks of...
That's how they pronounce it in Gloucester, isn't it?
Yeah. Gloucester boy in the borough, but...
90-0 they lost at the weekend.
Oh, I can't believe you just said that, Big Mac. But this is what we're doing today. We're going to have a little talk about the football results from the weekend and obviously predictions for tonight, tomorrow, Wednesday, Thursday and Friday with the playoffs of the Championship. Because obviously I'm going to England, as you all know, on Thursday to see my new grandson and what have you. And there's lots of other things happening over the weekend. So, as I said, I'm going to ad lib, do one or two little bits of videos, and we're just going to chuck them on and have a bit of fun. Right, it's as simple as that. Right, Kevin's here. If you just tuned in, Webby Sports Roundup, Sunny Tenerife, in my little manor. Oh, degrees,
27.
About 27 degrees.
Getting warmer and warmer. Yeah.
I just hope it's going to be similar when I'm back home on Thursday, but I don't think so. Be about 20, which I'm going to be happy with. Right, let's start off with the football. Don't forget, subscribe. Only subscribe if you're going to watch the videos, okay? That's what you're going to do. A Facebook page, my number 99, and do the like. That's it.
You've got thumbs up as well.
Thumbs up as well, because the more thumbs up we get, the more it goes round the world to Google, and they send everywhere for a bit of fun.
If you're going to do a thumbs down, don't bother.
Nah, don't bother. Cheers, sir. Right, we're going to start off with last weekend's football game. So there was a 12:30 kickoff. As you know, Fulham at Craven Cottage took on Man City, who's won the league champions for the last three years,
yeah.
And nobody's ever done four on the bench. And we think it's going to be four, but we'll have to wait and see.
I hope not for Sands.
There's one to do, permutations going to happen. And I did see some of the game. I'll tell you what, when you won a season ticket of those of that team.
They strolled it, didn't they? They strolled the game.
I thought Fulham on a...
I don't think Fulham had a shot on target.
No.
In the first half,
yeah,
they had no attempts on goal at all.
Unbelievable. Absolutely unbelievable game. They were good, Man City.
They are good.
They just stepped up to the gear, didn't they? Right, second game went down to the South. Bournemouth taking on Brentford. And the Bournemouth manager has just signed a brand new 2-year deal extension, which he deserves.
To 26, yeah.
Yeah, he's done super of any.
Do you know what? He started off the first 6-8 weeks. He struggled.
Good health.
But you know what? Bournemouth, as well as Crystal Palace, who again had a manager who struggled at first.
Yeah.
They're probably the two form teams taking Manchester City out of the equation.
Yeah. Prince William is just going past. We're going to
give him a wave.
Oh, Prince, how are you?
I think it's your missus.
He just put
it there. Been shot.
thanks very much. So, Bournemouth beat Brentford by 1-0. Everton took on Sheffield United. Sheffield United already down. Everton lost a few points through this financial fair play league.
It's awful game of football.
Yeah, I watched bits and it was terrible, wasn't it?
It was the last game of Match of the Day and they struggled to get 3 minutes out of it.
Oh dear, bad.
But it was a nothing game.
Yeah, it was nothing game. So Everton, my pal Big Mark, Mark of Everton, back in Liverpool, top boy, he'll be over to see me very, very soon. Ended up 1-0 to Everton. Newcastle took on Brighton. That could have gone either way.
Do you know what? Brighton are a queer team.
Very.
They can be very good or very average.
Yeah.
And they played well against Newcastle.
Yeah.
But Newcastle A point's good enough for them, but they'd have expected to win, and they didn't.
You did, yeah,
but
yeah.
They didn't lose.
But Brighton could have won the game. They played
yeah,
well,
yeah, yeah, they did, yeah.
They did play
yeah,
well.
It was a decent game.
Well, so it says Angels Park, Newcastle won, Brighton won. One of the big games, again, for a foggy mind, number 99, Tottenham taking on Burnley. Burnley had to win to give them any chance of staying in the Premiership. They were 1-0 up, just like Luton were 1-0 up at West Ham, and you think, here we go, second bottom, third bottom. Both 1-0 up away from them. Both need to win to keep them in the Premiership. But with lack of experience and lack of quality in their team and lack of a squad member, it ended up...
You watched the game?
I watched bits.
Do you know what? Burnley were a better team in the first
half. I agree. I did watch bits of it, I must admit.
But as you say, the lack of quality.
Yeah.
But the actual...
The
game of football,
yeah,
possession, yeah, passing the ball,
yeah,
they were the better team in the yeah, first half.
And Tottenham, Foggy was happy, they came out 2-1 winners.
Of course he was, yeah.
Keeps them in a chance of the Champions League. But as you know, it's top four, automatic Champions League. You've got Man City, Arsenal fighting for the Premiership title. You've got, obviously, Liverpool is going to be third for Defo. And then you've got Tottenham and Aston Villa. It's like this. They're going, who's going to win? Who's going to lose? Who's going to be fourth place? So we ended up Tottenham 2-1. West Ham United took on Luton Town in the last home game of the season. With, obviously, David Moyes. Luton, again, 1-0 up. And then with a lack of squad players, lack of quality, the effort was there, but you knew their heads dropped when West Ham scored a couple of goals.
You know, their season ended when they didn't beat Everton at home.
At home, yeah.
Friday before.
Yeah.
And I think the season has just taken its toll now.
Yeah.
They haven't got the legs anymore.
No.
I think it's sad they're going down because they've done fantastically well. Everybody, you included, me, thought they were going to finish the season look if they had 10 points, and they've done fabulous.
Well, that's what Terry says, they won't have 10 points into the season,
but it's been remarkable. But
obviously they beat Coventry in the playoffs last year with obviously Dabo missing the penalty, first 11 winning, then he missed, and it is what it is. But we all want them to stay up.
I was absolutely staggered how well they've done.
Fantastic.
Incredible.
All of us. They had some great home games against one of them.
Yeah,
Liverpool. Did they draw Liverpool?
I tell you what, nobody had an easy game against them.
No, no.
Nobody had an easy game against them.
And the manager I like, don't I?
Yeah, he's a lovely fellow. Isn't
lovely
he?
Fella.
You love him.
I do.
You love him. You love the way he dresses.
Yeah.
I think they'd marry him.
I think he's handsome.
John's worried.
Oh, no. I think he's fantastic.
You want your ever to meet him?
He talks a great story. One day I will meet him with a better. Just a lovely, lovely fella. So we ended up. And I'll tell you what the big thing was me. One or two good friends of mine, Foggy's mate, West Ham John from the Oakwood in Leon C.
He's been on your vlog, hasn't he?
Yeah,
yeah.
Oh, super! He does all this.
Yeah.
He was there, and he met one or two friends, and he met one of the big boys from years and years ago.
Ruddick?
No, a fan.
A fan.
One of the hard men.
Cass Bennett.
Yeah, great photograph with Cass Bennett.
Yeah, there's a film about him,
yeah,
didn't
it? Yeah, super. And the other thing I'll tell you.
My parents.
Yeah, he did. Super. And the other thing I want to commend West Ham United. West Ham United fans all applauded Luton Town Football Club when all the players came off the pitch.
That's fabulous.
And I saw it. But on my own eyes, they were absolutely super. So well done to West Ham United football supporters. Yeah. On the money.
Did they give, I didn't watch the game, did they give Moyes a good...
A good reception, yeah.
That's good.
He's been there 4.5 years.
That's good.
He's done the business.
I'm glad.
He's,
they are good fans.
They
are good fans.
One of the best, no doubt about that. A big shout to Wagsy, to Son Andy, to Cookie. They're all West Ham boys,
Sean.
To Sean Murphy, obviously.
Number four,
yeah.
Don't forget him. He's number four, man.
Yeah, he's been away for a few weeks, and he's back now. So it's all good. So well done to West Ham United, on the money. Let's move on to Wolverhampton Wanderers taking on the Palace. It was on a Saturday afternoon. Dawn's outside by the pool, and I've got 5-6 games on. And I'm going bang, 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 with horse racing. On my favourites, kept switching, and Palace.
Palace, the last 4 or 5 games, are playing some fantastic stuff.
Mm.
Them two wide lads are brilliant.
Oh.
And that big lad, the big French lad, Martin,
scores some goals, isn't he?
But you know what? What a home player he is as well. Yeah.
There's not many players.
He'll be a good side next year
if
they can keep the better players and get one or two in.
As you said, the manager, obviously.
They keep the ball from Blackburn for 18 million. Morton.
Yeah, yeah.
All of a sudden, he's looking as like a star. And I tell you what, England could do worse than checking him as one of the extra players.
Well, that's a big thing. We're going to have a big discussion on that. Me, Terry,
so wouldn't take Mount.
Make some money. No, not Jazz. Not Jazz. Not Jazz. All that money for him.
Yeah.
But yeah, we're going to have a big discussion on that. So when a few of the supporters are coming over to watch, we're going to talk about the 26 squad. So we've got big discussions on that in the next few weeks. So what is the Palace beating Wolverhampton Wanderers by 3-1? Chasing the three horseshoes, not a happy bunny.
Wolves have struggled the last few games, though, haven't they?
Yes, they have. Neto, one or two have been injured.
They've had lots of injuries.
Yeah, they've done well.
They seem to be on the beach a bit.
Let's move to the City ground. Nottingham Forest taking on the Gunners.
Best game of the weekend.
Phenomenal. We went there, just me and you, on our Jack Jones, weren't we?
In the
three horseshoes.
We won't say nothing.
Me and him.
Great.
I won't say it. He said something, and I came back with a joke, and me and him.
We're laughing for 24 hours, weren't we?
Obviously, tears, weren't it?
But what a great game. Getting back to the football, what a great game.
Yeah, and didn't they deserve some at Forest?
Do you know what they did? But they just lack it up front, don't they?
Yeah.
They just lack it up front.
It ended up Forest 2.
They stayed up.
Forest 2.
But it was a fantastic advert for football.
100%. And do you know, I'm glad they're staying up. And the owner, he's put his money where he's a
one of our best mates, Cass, is a Forest fan.
Yeah.
And I'm chuffed to bits for him. But he's always a glass half empty man, and he thought they're going to go down, But stayed up.
Was it 23, 24 players they bought last year?
Because they had so many loan players. So they had to go back to the club.
And that's a bring
in. He only had 12 players.
Yeah, gotcha.
That's all he had. They only owned 12 players.
But he still had to buy them.
But that's what they lost the points for.
Is he?
Because they had to buy a squad because they had all loan players.
Is he Turkish?
No, he's Greek.
Greek.
Big fat bloke.
Yeah.
Looks like Dennis Russo.
He's a lovely fella. He put his money where his mouth was, isn't he?
Would like to buy his dinner. Sound of him.
So one into the Gunners, 3-2 winners at City Ground. Let's move on to Man United Arsenal, the big game I've asked for. We're down to three horseshoes. Webby come, my son. Obviously Kev was there, I was there. Goya Dave was there. All the boys are there watching. Stevie from Los Menores. And I checked the stats. I watched it. They've only got probably, if they had all the players available, half those wouldn't have got in the side. When you've got Casemiro, who's nearly 40, you've got obviously Evans, who went to Leicester. You know what I mean? They're going to lose, aren't they? They're slow. You know, they look the lymphos
pressure to the road. But I'll be like the person who hasn't got rose tinted glasses.
Yeah.
Because you are a bit of a Man United follower.
Yeah.
And I thought Arsenal looked nervous.
Yeah.
The start of the game on fire.
Yeah.
And you sat there thinking, Jesus, this is going to be 4-5-0.
Yeah.
And they didn't score a goal.
No.
But then they got the goal 1-0, and then they seemed to just hold on for a 1-0 to the Arsenal scoreline.
Well, Garnacho on the wing, I mean, how many times?
He's just a greedy player.
Do you know why? He was here in Tenerife for a few days with his partner and their baby. Because they were seen at the airport, so where he stayed, I don't know. But perhaps he had too many sherbets again. But at the end of the day, he's greedy, wouldn't pass it. He messed up at the end.
Man U were the better team in the second half.
They had more shots.
They were the better team. And I think if Man U had equalised, it'd have put the fear of God into Arsenal. Because Arsenal just seemed to freeze that
they
team.
Did,
You know,
could they have upped their game, Arsenal? I don't know.
I'm not sure they could have.
No, could have. Right, that's ended up Man United 0, Arsenal 1. And I'll tell you what, we all saw the rain the last 10 minutes.
You know, their stadium.
Is that a disgrace?
Their stadium, for me, it should be closed down. If that, what can happen when they get heavy rainfall, then for me, it should be condemned.
Could be dangerous.
People
for the supporters.
Did you see the floods coming down? Somebody could have been swept away and killed.
Through the stands?
Yeah.
And it was down all the seats and everything.
The place should be closed down.
Yeah.
It's dangerous.
Yeah. Well, we've got the new guy Reynolds there and what have you, CEO, whatever you want to call him, but let's see what happens for next season. Right, last night's game.
Second best game of the weekend.
I saw the second half on that. Villa 3, Liverpool 3. I missed the first bit. I saw it was 2-1 to Liverpool. I believe the goalie messed up, did he, or not?
One minute in, and he had the ball, and then he threw it into his net, really. I don't know whether he took a bet on himself, but...
But Villa are funny, son. They went 13, 14, 15 games undefeated, wouldn't they?
I think the season took its toll on them the last 5 weeks. They're basically a team who, if they can get the best 12 or 13 players on the pitch, after that, they haven't got very much.
Yeah, for sure.
And I think it's took its toll. Thursday games, Sunday games, etc.
Well, you say Thursday game, but you're talking about the UEFA.
Yes.
It wasn't. It was
the conference.
The conference.
But for me, they've had an awful lot of games this season.
Yeah.
The squad isn't as much depth as other teams.
Yes, there's always excuses.
But if they finish in the top four, it's a fantastic season.
I think they will.
Don't care.
They need 1 point in two games.
Well, we're going to talk about tonight's is the game that is the one, isn't it? You know.
So Warren's a Villa, and they came back and scored two late goals.
Terrific game.
And I think they should have probably won in the end.
But what I would say about Liverpool,
yeah,
a bit of a systematic of how their season's gone. 3-1 up.
They changed. He had four changes.
He makes too many changes at once. He tries to be a bit too clever.
Yeah.
And he's done it loads of times this season. Instead of just trying to see the game out. And he makes changes just for the sake of
changes. He put Nunes on and whatever.
He didn't need to make the changes.
No.
They haven't got a game for Sunday.
He didn't bring Salah off because he thought...
But he's frightened him.
Yeah, he's frightened
him. He'd have had a fight on the touchline.
He would have had a problem, wouldn't he? So he'll ended up Villa 3 and Liverpool 3. Yeah. Right, that's all the games that's gone up till now. Right, we've got one or two games from now, so we're going to have some predictions by Kevin and myself.
Chris, can I just say?
Yeah, please do.
The top three are the top three, except the only things that to play for anymore now is the first and second place, and the place where Chelsea, Manchester United and Newcastle are involved.
Yeah.
So the next two nights, as we're going to get to them now,
Mega.
Massive evenings
for next year big
for the only things that anybody's got to play for this season.
Right, if you just joined the channel, this is going out today on a Tuesday, and the reason why it's going out, it's all a bit different. We're ad-libbing it on the basis that I'm off to England on Thursday for 4 days to see my new grandson and my other grandkids and my son and my daughter and whatever the case. That's what's happening, parties and what have you. So I'm just ad-libbing, putting one or two little vlogs together. Obviously Kevin's here for 2 or 3 weeks, so I've got him on board. We've had a bit of fun, we're having a laugh, and we're doing our football predictions. I asked Simon's had to go somewhere else, so he couldn't make it this afternoon. I didn't say to speak to Terry, because obviously Terry's busy up doing his last man standing and what have you, so that's what that. But we're back to normal next week. We've got big FA Cup final a week Saturday, which is going to be massive. Man City taking on Man United, should be Coventry City, as we all know. We were robbed on the last minute of the game for beating them Red Devils. Okay, end of
conversation. I'm going to start crying.
End of conversation. But you know what? It's all money.
I thought we were here to talk about the Premier.
Shut up! I'm talking.
Sorry.
Worldwide, Man City, Man United will bring in more revenue than Man City, Coventry, and I think that's the reason why. As far as I'm concerned, end of. I'm saying my piece.
He's wrong.
All right? I'm saying my piece. Right. We're going to have some predictions now. We're going on. So look, if you've just joined the channel, Webby Sports Roundup, here in sunny Tenerife, my little manor. My name's Paul Webb. Been here 30 years and three pubs later. Retired 9 years ago from the world famous Garden Bar. And now we're just talking football and sport. Today is the football show with Kevin and my good self, a big Borough fan. Subscribe if you want to. If you don't subscribe, that's not a problem. If you still want to watch the channel, please watch it. But hit that thumbs up. That's the big one. Thumbs up. And lots of comments. Because every comment I return and say many thanks. Thanks very much indeed. So plenty of comments, please. Take care. Right, before we go, let's go predictions now. We've got Tottenham Man City tonight. That's the big one, 8 o'clock kickoff.
I'm going to make a statement here.
Okay.
Which team do you think Guardiola has got the worst record against in the Premier League since he's been manager of Manchester City?
Well, obviously, there's obviously an answer there.
Spurs.
You're joking.
The last four games at Spurs, who's won them?
The last four?
Against Man City, last four games at Spurs, who's won them?
So Tottenham's won the last four at home?
Last four at home.
Could they make it five?
Spurs have got the best record against Manchester City out of any team by a distance.
Yeah.
Against Guardiola's Manchester City.
Gotcha.
I'm not saying Spurs are going to win because statistics can tell you anything.
Yeah.
But that's the facts. I can see a draw.
Okay, there's our prediction then.
I'm going to say it's a draw.
Yeah. Do you know what? I can't see City losing.
No.
Because I just think they're that good. Wouldn't you want to have a season ticket to watch them? They're just beautiful to watch. But the trouble is, when you know you win nearly every game, you get disappointed if you draw. So
Simon says Tottenham won't turn up.
Listen,
but I don't buy that. Like, they've got professional pride, haven't they?
Did you see that thing going around on social media this morning?
The vote?
No, all the Man City team are in the Marriott Hotel.
All right.
Okay.
Right.
And
they asked, right.
Supposedly, this I'm not going to say, Arsenal fans,
yeah,
it's got to be there.
Yeah.
They just gone fireworks, yeah, all around the Man
United. It's happened on countless occasions as different clubs.
Yeah, yeah. So that's and they said that when they're asleep this afternoon.
Do you think they were there, or do you think they said they were there and there was somebody else?
Who knows? Listen, yeah, yeah, does it matter? No. I still think Man City will be top.
I know you do.
I really do.
I hope for Simon's sake it's a draw.
Yeah.
But I do see where you're coming from.
Yeah, yeah, for sure.
They always hit the button at the right time, Man City. Right.
Oh, without any shadow of a doubt. Obviously, Haaland had a bit of a...
Well, I think it'll be an interesting, fantastic game.
Oh, for sure. It's going to be. Great atmosphere. It'll be good to watch. So,
but if Spurs win...
Oh,
they can finish fourth.
Yeah, yeah.
Because Aston Villa, I know we're not going to talk about...
They need one point. They need one point.
Put their away to Crystal Palace. And that's a hard Crystal Palace are the fourth team.
They need one point. Yeah, they've got two games left, haven't they, I think?
No.
Is it one?
One.
Just a Sunday, that's
away to Palace. Okay, tough game.
Yeah, yeah, gotcha, okay. That's the last one. Right, so you're going Tottenham draw.
I'm going to
go City win. All right? That's my heart telling me. That's what I think is going to happen. Right. Then on Thursday...
Wednesday.
Let me just tell you, before we go any further, just tell you where we are. We're in Sueño's Hall with a little brand new bar that's been open 2 or 3 months, and it's absolutely super. And it's called La Totufrita. It's spelled LATOTUFITA. In Sueño's Hall, we're round the corner, a little car park, and I'll tell you what, it's absolutely gorgeous.
Spotlessly clean.
Spotty clean, drinks lovely. He has to get some Heineken in if he wants me to keep coming back. So
and he'll have to sell it cheap.
Yeah, exactly. We'll have to sell
he
it cheap.
He doesn't spend money.
No, he does. Hey, that's a laugh, isn't it?
Cheap. Bit
of music. They do a bit of food and what have you, and it's lovely. And a nice guy who's on there. He's turned the music down so we can do our little vlog. So absolutely super. Right, let's move on to Brighton taking on Chelsea. Is that a Thursday?
It's Wednesday.
Both tomorrow night. Okay. Well, I think that's... you got them. So, Spurs, City tonight, beg your pardon. Yeah. Brighton, Chelsea.
Chelsea probably have to win. They've got 57 points. Newcastle have got 57.
Yeah.
Manchester United have got 54.
Yeah.
Manchester United's goal difference is minus.
Yeah, it's the worst.
Newcastle's is plus 22. Chelsea plus 12, I think.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So, if Chelsea win 60 points...
Yeah.
I think Chelsea will go there. I can't see them losing.
They turn the corner.
The Pochettino all of a sudden's turned the corner with them. I don't think they should sack him. I don't know whether they're even talking
about
him.
No.
It's absolute madness.
No.
It's just paper talk.
Yeah, yeah. Good manager.
I think it'll be a draw.
Yeah, yeah. I'm probably on the same postage stamp for that one. All right, let's go to Man United Newcastle. Oh, there's the water. I won't be out tonight, so I'm going out with Matthew and Faye.
Yeah,
who's obviously.
I'm meeting you in there tomorrow night to watch the Man U.
I'll be in tomorrow night to watch the Man United Newcastle. I'll be, if anybody's in the area and they're in Kelsavaki, pop into the Three Horseshoes in my little corner, in Webber's corner, in the Three Horseshoes, watching the football.
If Man United lose, that means the top seven are what the top seven are now.
That's at this moment in time.
Absolutely. Man United have to win that game.
Yeah.
To have the same points as Newcastle, but they still wouldn't go above Newcastle.
No.
Because the goal difference is inferior.
Okay. You've been doing your homework, kid?
I always do, mate.
I know you do. Yeah, you know you do well. Yeah.
Even though when I get woke up at 9 o'clock and say, are you going to do this today with me?
Do you know something? I didn't realise.
That's true.
He was showing off a couple of days ago because he told me he had 9 O-levels and I thought, you're having a laugh. But he did. He's always an introvert when he was doing his job. But now, obviously, he's out with me doing a bit of footy news. He's an extrovert, okay? An extrovert.
I am in the pub if we're talking.
That's what I mean.
Stuff, but not.
No, not.
No,
not when you meet Julie.
No, no.
No, I agree.
No,
I agree. Or she give you a slap.
Exactly.
It is what
so
it is.
So, what were you saying about Man U and Newcastle? You haven't made a decision. I'm going to say it's a draw. I can see both games tomorrow night, please.
I can see United beating them. After Arsenal,
is that your heart rule in your head?
No. I think that's because they had 55% possession against Arsenal, 45 for Arsenal. They had more shots, not the same. They had more shots against Arsenal than Arsenal did.
I hope for your sake they do.
Yeah, and for Matthew North and everybody else.
But for me, I can't see it.
No, I think they're turning it in.
Fernandes
Going
to Saudi.
Is that right? Is
what
that
talking?
Is that talking? Yeah, there's everything's talking. Stevie Gerrard. He wants Tavernier from Rangers in one or two others. Yeah. So listen, it is what it is. We'll see what happens over the summer period. Right, so I'll say United win.
Okay, I'll say draw.
All right, say draw. Okay. Right, there's two Championship playoffs. If you've had your bed buried in the sand, Leeds, Southampton, Norwich City, and West Bromwich Albion became 3, 4, 5, and 6 in the playoffs. Championship, who's going to go into the Premiership and earn $200 million for next year? That's what the figure is obviously out about. So
both first games, 0-0 tentative draws.
Awful. I watched it, turned it off.
Nobody wanted to lose.
I'd rather watch Coronation Street. Yeah. It was that bad. Yeah,
Coventry at the push.
But yeah, you know you're right. Nobody wanted to lose, so
no.
I think we both predicted.
Makes these games excellent.
Yeah, the two. This is it. I predicted Leeds Southampton final.
We did. Yeah, we did. We said this weeks and weeks ago, didn't we?
Yeah, I'm sorry.
And I'm not going to change from that.
I'm sorry to all the baggy supporters, to Glyn, the dad of the three horses.
Yeah, lovely fella.
Yeah, absolutely on the money. And to Sarah Childs, who's a big Norwich City fan. I just think
I can't say any other because Julie, she's a Leeds fan.
She's a big Leeds fan. I did still say,
but I don't think
Southampton, me, I just think they're hitting it right to go and win.
Although they were pretty poor with you the other day, but they're a decent home team.
Yeah, they're a good side. Adam Armstrong up front, ex Coventry.
Yeah,
he can knock them in.
I think if it does end up as Leeds Southampton, which we think it will, we could be wrong.
Yeah.
I think it'll be a close call.
Yeah. But if you take all the players, I'll go back to Coventry again. Adam Armstrong, ex-Coventry, scoring goals for fun, Southampton playing well. Then you had Connor Chaplin.
I thought he was at Ipswich.
He is. Yeah. I should say, yeah, he went at Ipswich. They've gone in the top. Yeah. They were second in the league. So all players that we've got rid of, Madison, Tottenham, you know what I mean? We've got rid of some great players. Yeah. And they've moved on to better things. So we hope.
Where did you finish in the league,
didn't you? Ninth. You were seventh.
I know you were below us, weren't you?
You were seventh.
We were eighth.
We
were 6 points ahead,
didn't you? Yeah, we were ninth, yeah.
We're covering you wonderful, apparently. Well, they're not. The Borough are.
But do you want to bet for next season?
No. I don't bet. See, no,
there's your ass.
I don't want money to bet.
See, what I'm saying is, he won't put his mouth. All right, money where his mouth is.
Not like you, right? Mr. Rich.
Oh, you're having a tin bath, then. Not to be a pound on your bank balance, that's for sure. Especially working as a prison officer for 31 years, pal. That's for sure. Hey, excuse me.
Some would say I didn't work, I just turned up.
That's all I've been
talking about. Julie in particular.
Right, listen. We've got Leeds United taking on Norwich City, Elland Road.
I'm going to say 2-1 Leeds.
Yeah, I'll go 1-0.
Do you think it'll be a tight game?
I think it'll be very, very tight again, but I think they'd be scared to come out just in case Norwich have a break when they started. But I still think I think Leeds will come out 1-0 winners.
Right.
Okay. All right. 1-0 winners. Let's move on to Southampton taking on West Bromwich Albion.
I'm going to say 3-0 to Southampton. I have a feeling
they'll be on real form.
I think they'll beat them 3-0.
3-0. Okay.
I hope for Glyn's sake that's not the case.
No.
But I just have a feeling.
I think the Baggies have got a goal in them. To tell you the truth, because when we played them before, we played them on the way. They're a big side, big lump.
They're a big, they're strong team,
Big lump, big.
Yeah, and they're big and strong.
Yeah. So I think they might bully Southampton a little bit and score.
Do
you? Yeah, I do. Yeah,
you think Southampton will win?
2-1. Yeah. I think Southampton's got enough there.
Okay.
I think it'll be 2-1.
As we say, we think it'll be Leeds Southampton in the final.
In the final, and I think that'll be.
And I think it'll be a grip.
That'll be a cracker. Yeah. That'll be a cracker. Right, listen, that's what we've got time for today. But I'll tell you what, before we go, lately I've been given a few horse tips out, okay? I've given a few with Lee Sobot on my live show, and we've done really, really well. We got the Tour of the Nationals 18-1, 8-1 winners, superb. Be giving a little bit of a tip for tonight. Now, don't go mad on it, all right? I get tips good, tips bad, but we've had a good little run lately, okay? So if you see this before, it's at Killarney tonight over in Ireland. And you know what Irish race is like?
Oh, okay? That's the name of the racetrack, not the horse.
The name of the racetrack. So it's number 13, 1-3. Number 13, each way in the 6:50. It was 9-1 last night. When I checked this morning, it was 11-1. It's drifted.
Oh, so it's going out.
Have a little bit each way, okay? Don't go mad, but there'll be more tips to come in the near future, all right? I have one or two good contacts. And we'll see as it is. So the Killarney tonight, 6:50, because this is going out tonight at 4 o'clock, sharp, And then it's number 13, each way, a little bit each way, the 6:15.
Lucky for some.
Cannot, yeah, could be unlucky for some. So listen, that's what it's all about. What a cracking little half an hour we've had there.
Yeah, very good. Thoroughly
enjoy it.
Very good.
At least I'll put it on the... we put the phone on there, haven't we? Made it fun. But don't forget, we are in La Totofita, which is the little bar and restaurant around the back of Sueño's Hall. People don't even know it's here. Have a little walk round, pop in, have a coffee, have a beer, a little bit of lunch on there. You've got papas, you've got various bits of tortilla. It's lovely. If they get some Heineken in, then I'll be using it a little bit more. Got a TV on. It's just a nice relaxing. You know, that's what it basically is. It's super. So, Kevin?
Goodbye from me, and it's goodbye from him. He can have the last word because he's the number one and he loves to have the last word. It's been a pleasure.
If you just tuned in to my channel, Webby Sports Radio, here in sunny Tenerife, we do football, sport, every week. I'm off to England on Thursday, so basically, as you all know, so what it is now, it's a bit of an ad lib. One or two bits we're putting in. 15 questions we've got coming up on the weekend with a big man, then I'll put that. And don't forget, I'm like a dinosaur. So there's one or two little hiccups and problems, but it ended up well. It always does, doesn't it? I don't do all this, adverts and editing and what have you. You get what you get from me, all right? So hit the like button, because the more likes we get, it goes to Google, and Google sends it out to every single person in the world. And on top of that, if you want to subscribe, please. But only subscribe if you're going to watch the show. It's as simple as that. So, good luck to everybody. You have a great weekend. Good luck to all the football clubs and the predictions that we've done. Cheers to Foggy, Facebook page. He's my number 99 in the Oakwood in Leon C. If you're over there, pop in, see the staff and say, put it on Foggy's bill. And he will absolutely wet himself, I promise you. So all I'm going to say is...
You won't go in again.
If you like what you see and you like what you hear, subscribe to Webby Sports Radio here in my manor in the south of Tenerife. Kevin, cheers, big man.
Yeah, cheers, mate. Thanks.
Top boy.
And good luck when you're away.
Thank you. And I'll see you when you come back.
Yeah, absolutely.
So for me, Webby, I'll see you on the next one. Take care.